adipose-derived stem cell injections for androgenetic hair loss more effective than PRP with ACell? I have female androgenetic alopecia and am interested in either PRP with ACell or adipose stem cell injections with PRP. Adipose stem cell scalp injections are more expensive, and I'm wondering if they give better results.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question without a photo. And you're asking in this question, is adipose-derived stem cell treatment for hair loss better than PRP and ACell? You state in your question that you have female pattern hair loss or androgenetic alopecia, and you're aware that the adipose-derived stem cell treatment is more expensive than PRP and ACell, and you want to know, is it better? Well, I can certainly share with you my perspectives on this question, which is certainly something that comes up in our practice fairly frequently. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a system used by us, developed by us, over the past 7 years of using PRP with acellular matrix and having developed systems and algorithms of dosing and intervals that are unique to the methods that we employ using the system for both men and women with hair loss, androgenetic alopecia. So to begin with this, the concept of what are we doing when we're treating female pattern hair loss. We have to begin with what is the cause of female pattern hair loss. And the reality is, besides the word genetics, there is no known associated factor, as opposed to male pattern hair loss, where there is at least the awareness of something called dihydrotestosterone, or DHT, that's a variable that is potentially treatable in male pattern hair loss. Female pattern hair loss, essentially the only pharmaceutical intervention is minoxidil, 5% foam, relatively recently approved, and otherwise there has been nothing else. When we started doing ACell-PRP combination over 7 years ago, we were doing it for transplants, for hair transplant surgery. And it was done for the purpose of improving the healing and yield of the hair grafts, as well as the healing of the donor area. A side effect seen in some patients was that thinning hair became thicker. So it became an opportunity for me to look into the feasibility of using this as a way to treat hair loss. Now, we have to also understand that there is no cure for hair loss. What we are essentially doing is we are managing hair loss. And what have we learned from our clinical experience? With a specific concentration of acellular matrix, platelet-rich plasma, injected in a specific way, we can reactivate hair that isn't growing. Now, what does that mean? Essentially, when hair is thinning, the growth cycles get shorter and the resting phases get longer. By definition, that means there are fewer hairs, which is greater than the normal percentage, which is usually somewhere around 8 to 10% of hairs, that are not actively growing because of the prolonged resting phase. Stimulation of hair growth is observed by the reactivation and growth. What else do we see? We see thinning hairs becoming thicker, so therefore hair quality improves. You add numbers with quality and you get better coverage. Now, what we have learned over time is that patients come with different lengths of hair growth cycles, depending on a lot of variables which we have ultimately created into an algorithm. And this algorithm is based on gender, age of onset, duration of hair loss, rate of progression of hair loss, and degree of hair loss. In addition, for women, looking at other hormonal factors. With that being said, with TrichoStem hair regeneration, we have been able to get consistent improvement with the overwhelming majority of women with female pattern hair loss. Now, sometimes there is a mixed picture. Sometimes a female pattern hair loss patient will also have some hormonal irregularities, even though it may not be detected by the blood tests. And there is some patients who also happen to have some degree of chronic telogen effluvium. There can be patients who also have telogen effluvium or shedding due to stressors. So that being said, when we think of what it is that we are trying to, what we're accomplishing, the mechanism of action still remains unclear. But one variable that I think is probably contributing to this is based on the work that has been done using fat. And this is where we start to look at the adipose-derived stem cells. What essentially is the premise is that with liposuction and then processing of what's known as stromal vascular fraction, or SVF, you can inject fat cells into the scalp and get essentially a fat grafting effect. So what is essentially a common thread between the two procedures? Well, basically, as is observed when I use PRP and an ACell into this in the skin, is that the fat cells improve. And this has been shown in study after study in histology. Basically, stimulating of fat cells has a benefit to skin. We can therefore transfer that idea into better, more stem cell activity in the scalp, resulting in probably some positive benefit in the fat cells, which thereby affects the hair growth cycles. So then the question is, what is better? Well, I am a cosmetic surgeon, and liposuction has been a very big part of my practice. So harvesting fat is no problem. My objection to fat transfer or fat grafting compared to acellular matrix and PRP is that, first, is it worthwhile to put a patient through the harvesting of the fat and this placement? Placement of fat into the scalp is much more traumatic than injecting acellular matrix and PRP. With that trauma comes a certain degree of risk related to inflammation and as well as potential for bleeding. A recent study done, I believe, in behalf of a particular medical processing unit, a device to process fat, was done on a small group. I believe it was under 10 people. In that group, where fat was harvested and processed, they were able to show some benefit in a handful of those patients. Of the, I believe, 9 patients that were in the study, only 6 of them remained in the study, and several were lost to follow-up. The numbers are too small to make significant comparisons. What we can conclude is that fat transfer does have some benefit in hair growth in some patients, according to that study. When we look at our own history of treating patients with acellular matrix and PRP and developing hair regeneration and the algorithm, it has been my decision throughout this time, and it may change if we find something better with adipose-derived stem cells, it is my decision that essentially there is no advantage that I can see of using fat grafting over the injection of ACell and PRP. In addition, when we think of the management of hair loss, we have to think of growth cycles. We have to think of longevity and maximizing sustainability. That means timing of injections when there is more than one injection necessary. I think it's very difficult for patients to undergo multiple fat grafting sessions, as well as go through the risk and the trauma and the amount of swelling that is associated. One patient in that small study had a hematoma. That means there was a lot of bleeding under the scalp, and that is a complication that is, in my opinion, avoidable by using ACellular matrix and PRP. So I think you should look into the options, because as far as ACell and PRP is concerned, all practitioners are not equal. I think it's important that you find a practitioner who has extensive experience with female pattern hair loss, the use of ACellular matrix and PRP, who have been doing this treatment for years, and not the overwhelming group of people who are joining the parade and doing it only for a relatively short period of time and are still learning. I think it's important to understand that there is a necessity for customization in order to get the best outcome in managing hair loss, whether it's for women or for men. And so, in conclusion, thus far, I would not recommend adipose-derived stem cells over ACellular matrix and PRP. Learn more, and hopefully this was helpful to you. Once again, I hope this was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.